Hi, my name is Dave Cormier. When I develop something, an educational activity for the web, my first thought is always to try to remember the first 2 minutes of my classroom. Like, what happens if I'm standing, if I'm teaching kids or teaching adults, same thing happens. Stand in front of the classroom, I meet people at the door, maybe I'm meeting them in the hallway. I'm saying hi to people, I'm getting a sense of where they're at, I'm trying to get a sense of where the tensions might be inside the classroom. You can just look at somebody and say, that person done well learned today. Or when you first start out, your activity, when you first start, you can tell they weren't quite ready for it. You can tell as you are teaching, again, that people aren't getting it. All of those things need to be accounted for in some way in a web space. You have to have some way to bring your personality to that space, some way to allow people to form some kind of community, to form some kind of connection with you, with each other, some way to allow for the humanness of the process. Not that it's not possible. It's that it doesn't directly translate. So what I've seen people do over the years is they tend to think of a learning content management system, something like Moodle, and they think of it like they're writing an essay. So they write a big, giant piece of text in a really, really formal language as an introduction, whereas in your classroom, your verbal introduction is likely to be a lot less formal than that. It's likely to have some jokes in it. It's likely to try to get people warmed up less than trying to transfer information to them. And I think that if you can get your mind around that, start thinking about what your skill sets are, what things that you have to bring to that conversation, what ways other people bring their personality to web spaces, you'll be able to better prepare your students to be involved in the learning process, maybe empower them a little bit more, and make that a much more human activity. The web can be a really powerful place. I mean, you think of things like the discussion forum. It allows for a much broader, more egalitarian usage of voice for those people who are a little quieter, who need to think a little bit deeper. Something like a discussion forum gives them that time to be able to say the things they want, be part of those conversations, rather than having the uber extroverts talking all the time. So it's an example of how the web's actually a better place for discussion in some ways. And I think that's also true in terms of your design. You just got to think your way through how to bring your own human, happy, engaging, encouraging self to those kinds of web spaces. Cheers.